Hey, Holden Chapel Kids. Welcome to worship. The Bible teaches us many names for God. In today's story, we will learn about how God introduced himself as I Am. God is I Am because he is alive today. Our God is the God of the past, the present, and the future. Let's worship the great I Am by singing about some of his other names.
He's coming on the clouds, kings and kingdoms will bow.
activity time. Today's activity is called On Holy Ground. For today's activity, you will need paint, a paintbrush, and paper. Or, if you have it, you can use wood or a blank canvas. Have everyone in your family remove their shoes and socks. Paint the bottom of 1 foot of each person, then press it onto paper, wood, or the blank canvas. Pause the video while you complete this activity, then press play when you are ready. Have fun! Have you ever met someone and they immediately ask you to take off your shoes? That may sound strange, but that's what happened to Moses. Moses was working as a shepherd when God spoke to him. God said, "Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you are standing is holy ground." Let's listen to the beginning of Moses' story and God's plan for his life.
Years after Joseph brought his family to Egypt, Joseph died. His family stayed in Egypt. They were known as Israelites because they came from the family of Jacob, who was called Israel. A new Pharaoh came to power, and he was afraid of the Israelites. The family had grown so big. Pharaoh worried they would join Egypt's enemies and fight against him. Pharaoh made the Israelites slaves and gave them very hard work to do, but their families kept growing. Pharaoh ordered for all their baby boys to be killed. Around this time, a woman gave birth to a son. She hid him as long as she could, and then she put him in a basket and set it along the banks of the Nile River. The baby's older sister, Miriam, stayed nearby and watched the basket. Soon, Pharaoh's daughter went to the river to take a bath. She found the basket and saw the crying baby. Pharaoh's daughter felt sorry for the baby and wanted him to be her son. The princess named the baby Moses. When Moses grew up, he saw an Egyptian man mistreating an Israelite man. Moses killed the Egyptian. Pharaoh found out what Moses did and he was angry. So Moses fled Egypt. He worked as a shepherd in Midian for many years. Moses got married and had a family. Still, the Israelite people in Egypt were miserable, and they cried out to God. God heard them, and he planned to help them. One day, Moses saw a burning bush. The bush was not burning up. Suddenly, God called from the bush, "Moses, Moses!" Moses replied, "Here I am." God told Moses to take off his sandals because Moses was standing on holy ground. Then God said, "I have seen how my people are suffering. I want you to lead them out of Egypt to a good land I have for them." Moses wondered if the Israelites even remembered God. "What if they ask for your name? What should I tell them?" "I am who I am," God said. "Tell them, I am, has sent me to you." "What if they don't believe me?" Moses asked. So God gave Moses 3 miraculous signs to prove that God had appeared to him. Moses' staff would turn into a snake. His hand would become diseased and then healed. And the water from the river would turn into blood. Moses still made excuses and said, "Please send someone else." Now God was angry, but he agreed to send Moses' brother Aaron with him. So Moses went to Egypt. God saved Moses' life and called him to rescue God's people from slavery. The calling of Moses points to a greater calling and rescue. the call of Jesus to come to earth to save God's people. Jesus gave up his life to save us from slavery to sin.
Let's dig into God's Word and find out what God wants us to learn from this story. After each question is read, pause the video and talk about your answers together. Then press play when you are ready. First question. How did Moses first react when God called him to deliver his people from captivity? Moses had a lot of questions and excuses for why he wasn't the right person. He told God that he wasn't good at speaking. He even asked God to send someone else. It seemed like Moses was afraid to obey God. Perhaps he was afraid to go back to Egypt because of his past. Remember, the last time Moses was in Egypt, he had killed an Egyptian, and Pharaoh was very angry. Through all of the excuses Moses gave, God did not waver. God called Moses to deliver his people from captivity, and God was going to be the one to help him do it. In 2 Corinthians 12, God tells us that his grace is sufficient for us, for his power is made perfect in weakness. Next question. Why can it be hard to obey God sometimes? The Bible has many commands that we should obey. Loving our neighbor, loving our brothers and sisters, even loving our enemies, telling others about Jesus, and honoring and obeying our parents. These are all commands, not just suggestions. These commands can be hard to obey because we are sinners. Sometimes we only think about ourselves. Sometimes it's hard to love others, especially when they aren't nice to us. Sometimes we're afraid that people will reject us if we tell them about Jesus. Through it all, we can trust God to help us obey him, no matter what the circumstances are or how we feel. We don't have to wait for a burning bush to talk to us in order to obey God's commands.
You are here. working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working.